Students, in today's session, I'm going to discuss trick to solve chain isomerism and position isomerism questions easily. First, let us discuss what is this isomerism. Two compounds which are having same molecular formula but they have different physical and chemical properties are known as isomers, and the phenomena is known as isomerism. To save the time, I wrote here, see this. They have the same molecular formula but different physical and chemical properties. To understand this better, I'll give you an example. CH3, CH2, OH, CH3, OCH3. What is the molecular formula, students? Here, how many carbons are there? 2. And how many hydrogens total? 6 and oxygen. Molecular formula is C2H6O. For this also molecular formula is C2H6O. Both are having the same molecular formula. It is alcohol. It is ether. And it is a liquid. It exists in gaseous state. Coming to its properties, it reacts with hydrogen iodide. It reacts with hydrogen iodide and it forms CH3CH2I. CH3CH2I. It reacts with HI and it forms CH3I. It reacts with sodium. And alcohols releases hydrogen gas, whereas ethers won't react with sodium. These two compounds which are having the same molecular formula but they have different physical and chemical properties, that is the reason these two, alcohols and ethers, are isomers of each other. At least one physical or chemical property should be different, student. That is enough. Any one property, if different also, those two are isomers. Suppose if all the properties are same, then both will become identical. Isomerism is of two types. One is structural and stereo. Structural isomerism means two isomers which are having the same, two compounds having the same molecular formula but they have different structures, we call it as structural isomerism. It's a rough few types in the chain isomerism and position isomerism I'm going to discuss now. Watch the video up to the end. You are going to do the questions on chain isomerism and position isomerism on your own. And I'm going to give you test yourself question at the end. Chain isomerism means two compounds with the same molecular formula but different size of parent chain or different size of side chain. Then those two are known as chain isomers. What is this, students? Molecular formula anyway it will be same but size of side chain or size of parent chain should be different. Then those two are known as chain isomers. Example, normal butane and 2-methyl propane. Here how many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a parent chain. What is a parent chain? The longest chain which consists of any functional group is there. Along with the functional group, you have to choose the longest chain. This is the parent chain. How many carbons are there? 4. 1, 2, 3. Here how many carbons are there? 3 carbons. So here what is different? Parent chain is different. If parent chain is different or side chain is different, then those two isomers are known as chain isomers. Let us see position isomers. Two compounds with same molecular formula, same size of parent chain and same size of even side chain also. Both should be same, but different positions of functional groups, different position of functional group or multiple bonds, double bond or triple bond, position of substituent, nothing but side chain. Those are known as position isomers, and the phenomena is known as position isomerism. Count here, how many carbons are there in longest chain? This is the longest chain with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 carbons. Here, how many carbons in longest chain? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Parent chain is same. Parent chain is same. And side chain also. Side chain, what is the side chain? Methyl group. Side chain also same. But what is different? Here position is it. Sorry, numbering is. I gave wrong numbering. According to IUPAC convention, side chain should get the lowest number, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Side chain got, what is the numbering? 2. And here side chain got the numbering 3. So both are differ in the position of the side chain. That is the reason these two are position isomers. Let us see the trick. Isomerism means two compounds should have same molecular formula, but at least any one physical or chemical property should be different. Coming to the side chain isomerism, parent chain or side chain should be different. Position isomerism, parent chain or side chain should be same, or and position of either functional group, multiple bond, substituent, nothing but side chain should be different. Understand position, not nature. Nature of functional group, multiple bond and substituent should be same, but their position should be different, then only we call it as position isomers. And coming to this chain isomers, I already told you, both should be different. Let us see the questions. Structure 1, 2. Let us find the relation between these two. Do students along with me, you also take a rough notebook and start doing. How many carbons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Parent chain is different. Here 5, here 4. Both are chain isomers. Next question. Give numbering. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Both have same parent chain and side chain also same, but position is different. Here second, here third. So both are position isomers. Third question. 1, 2, 3. 3 carbons. Here also 3 carbons. And coming to this, parent chain is same and side chain also consists of only one carbon. Side chain consists of one carbon. Here also one carbon. Both have same side chain and same parent chain. Both are same, but position should be different, then they are called as position isomers. So these two are position isomers. Example 4. How many carbons in cyclohexane? 6. Here also 6. Parent chain is same, but side chain consists of 2 and here 1. Different side chain. So these two are chain isomers. Either parent chain or side chain should be different. Here 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Same number of parent chain and side chain 2, side chain 1, 1. Different side chains. Then these two are chain isomers. And here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Same parent chain and side chain consists of 2. And one side chain, 2 carbons, one side chain, 1 carbon. Here, one side chain, 2 carbons, other also 1 carbon. So, both have same parent chain and same side chain, but position is different. Then, these two are position isomers. I hope you understand this well. Let us solve little advanced question. Write all the possible structures of molecular formula C6H12. Here, I gave the hint, it is a cyclohexane. Cyclohexane, 6 carbons. What you have to do is, you have to first write the all possible structures with the 6 carbons. What I do is, first I wrote 6 carbon, cycloalkane, next 5, 4, 3. 2 is not possible with cyclic compounds, you can't draw. Now, total 6, right? 5 I wrote. How many left? 1 is left. 4 I wrote. A total 6. How many left? 2 is left. 2. 3 I wrote. Out of 6. How many left? 3 is left. So, these 3. With 4 cyclohexane. Again, any other possibility is there with this structure? No other possibility. For this, if you put this here also, it will be same. It will be, if you put the same side chain here also, it will be same. What I do now is, with 4 carbons, cyclobutane, this total, how many are there? 2 carbons are there. So, 2 carbons, ethyl group, I write it as 2 methyl groups. Right, this is one possibility. And one more possibility is, one methyl group I'll place here and one I'll place here. And one more possibility is, I put one here or one here. Next, to this. Total how many carbons are there? 3. How we can split it? 2 carbons and 1 carbon. This is one structure. Same thing, I change its position here. One possibility. If I put this here also, it will be same. One more possibility is, this 2 carbons, again, we can write it as ethyl group as 2 methyl groups and like this. And one more thing, positions I'll change. And this propyl group, we can write it as isopropyl group also. See here, I'm writing as isopropyl group. Now, how many total possible structures are there, students, for this? 1, 2, total 12 possibilities are there. Now, the question is, find the relationship between, test yourself question is, find the relationship between structure 1 and 2. 1, 2, what is the relation? Structure 2, 3, what is the relation? 3, 4, what is the relation? 4, 5, what is the relation? 5, 6, what is the relation? 6, 7, what is the relation? 7, 8, what is the relation? 8, 9, what is the relation? Like this, practice the relation between all these things and comment me your answer. I'm going to give the answer link in the description box. I hope you like this video. And thanks for watching. The students, the main thing is, one question I'll solve and show you. How many carbons are there here? 6 carbons. 6 in the main chain. Here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5. Main chain is different. Parent chain number of carbons is different. So, this is which isomerism? Chain isomerism. If main chain is same, parent chain and side chain is same, but position is different, then those are position isomers. Thanks for watching.